Hi, I'm Marty Pfeiffer, a TA at College of the Canyons. I'm going to walk you through getting started with a brush tool in Adobe Photoshop. As a brand new user of Photoshop, you're probably going to be using a newbie method to modify the brush size and hardness. As you get more familiar with Photoshop, you're going to find that keyboard shortcuts are helpful for changing the brush tool. As a pro user, you're going to want to use an interactive method to make changes to the brush by using mouse gestures. So let's talk about how to get started. I already have Photoshop open. I'm going to go ahead and choose the brush tool, and let's just make a simple drawing. Something's wrong. Nuts. Okay, here's tip number one. Don't let your little sister play with Photoshop before your presentation. So how do we fix this problem? We can reset the brush tool, and it's actually pretty easy. You just right-click on the brush icon in the options bar, and then select Reset Tool from the pop-up menu. Here, I'll demonstrate. I go over to the brush tool icon in the options bar, right-click, and select Reset Tool. And bam, it's like it never happened. Now that that's fixed, let's talk about how you would make your own changes to the brush tool. This is how a newbie would start out. You click on the brush tip in the drop-down menu, and then you can adjust the sliders of the size. So let's try that. I'm starting out with a big brush, and we want something smaller. I'm going over to the brush tip menu, and then changing the slider down to something smaller. And then when we paint again, we're now using a smaller brush size. Perfect. You can also adjust the sliders for hardness. Here's a hard brush tip. The edge of the brush is very defined. If you want a softer tip, you change the hardness down to a lower number using the sliders. And there you go. Pretty easy. Now let's talk about what a more advanced user would do. There are keyboard shortcuts you can use to change the brush size. You type the closing bracket to make the tip larger, and then you can press the opening bracket to make the tip smaller. So let's try that. We have a small brush tip, and then we want to make a larger line. So we're going to type the closing bracket a few times and increase the size of the brush. And there we go. You can also add the shift key, which technically gives you a curly bracket, and adjust the hardness in a similar way. I'm using the closing curly bracket by pressing the shift and typing the closing bracket a few times. This makes the tip harder, which results in a brush that's more defined and less fuzzy on the edges. Here's a handy little cheat sheet. Smaller with the opening bracket, larger with a closing bracket. Softer with the opening curly bracket, and harder with the closing curly bracket. But is there an even faster way to adjust the brush? You bet there is. Let's talk about how the pros use Photoshop. A lot of times when you see videos on YouTube of people doing Photoshop drawing demonstrations, you'll see the brush tip will change to a red, and then they start painting with a different type of brush. I've always wondered how they do that. Here's how it works. On the Mac, you press down the Control and Option keys, and then click and hold the mouse. On the Windows side, you hold down the Alt key and right-click and hold the mouse. This puts the brush into a special mode where you can use mouse gestures to interactively change the size and hardness. As you see, after making this little drawing, I get a red dot here, and that's indicating the size the new tip will be. So I'm adjusting the size by moving the mouse from left to right. And we also want a smaller, softer brush tip. So I'm moving the mouse up while also making it smaller. And there we go. Once I've got the tip set, I release the mouse button, and now we're painting with a different brush tip, and we didn't have to go through any menus at all. I hope this was helpful for you, and that you continue to learn more about Photoshop. Thanks for watching, and you're welcome.